has been making great efforts to increase the miles per gallon on its current fleet. Take, for example, this Talbot Horizon 1.5 GL. It's a new economy model that the company has just brought out specifically to counter economy claims made by other car manufacturers. Now, the car works on a well-known policy, and that is that if you put a big engine in a small car, it actually means more and not less economy than a small engine in a small car. Obviously, the engine in this Horizon is having to work a lot less hard than smaller engines in the Horizon range. A bigger engine can pull higher gears, and that leads to easier cruising at lower engine speed. Right, well, Talbot say that if I climb into this car and drive off into the Coventry traffic, and I don't drive like a maniac, and I am careful with the accelerator pedal, that I should be able to get more than 50 miles a gallon out of it, which sounds too good to be true, much too much of a challenge to resist. So let's set this computer back to naught, and off we go.
Well, while Pam's out trying to match the Talbot's claimed figures, as you can hear, I am very near Heathrow Airport in central London. In fact, a couple of hundred yards away from the place where the aeroplanes are actually taking off, at the Heathrow Hotel, to see what Volkswagen are up to. Because Volkswagen Audi, or VAG as they call themselves these days, are holding an energy symposium here today. And while the company as a whole is spending as much as on research and development as any other major motor manufacturer, the emphasis here seems to be on changing the driver's motoring behaviour to get him to drive in the most economic way possible. Perhaps the most important feature of the VAG package is the offer of a complete range of economy versions of their popular cars. That's the Polo, the Derby, the Golf, the Jetta, the Passat and the Audi 80. The economy cars all bear the family badge Formula E and will be sold in Volkswagen showrooms alongside the standard cars. The specifications vary from model to model, but they all come with a gear shift indicator. Now, this is basically a warning light up there on the dashboard, which indicates when the sensors in the car tell you that you should be changing up. Now, you, like me, may well be a little worried about the car telling you what to do, but if you want to save petrol, you'll do as you're told. Now, allied to this light is a fuel consumption meter. This comes on when you're in top gear, and it demonstrates quite graphically how too much pressure on the accelerator means you're just throwing away fuel. The Formula E cars feature special gearboxes with very high top gears in both 4- and 5-speed versions. The Polo, Golf and Jetta models have a 1.1-litre super economy 50-horsepower engine, and the Golf and Jetta models feature aerodynamic front spoilers. On the Passat and Audi 80 models, the package includes a stop-start facility. When you come to rest at a set of traffic lights or in a traffic queue, you simply flick a lever on the steering column. When you want to start off, you simply press the clutch and throttle pedal, and the engine automatically starts again, and off you go. VW say that if the stop in traffic or at the lights lasts more than 5 seconds, you save fuel by switching off. Savings in overall consumption in town driving can be as high as 30%.
Right, well, let's see how we did. Right, well, I've been out for just over 24 minutes, travelled just over 15 miles, used 0.3 of a gallon, which means that I averaged 43.8 miles per gallon. Well, it wasn't quite the 50 miles per gallon that Talbot promised, but in fairness, I did hit quite a bit of heavy traffic, so I think on a longer journey, 50 miles per gallon wouldn't have been out of the question, so I'll settle for that.